Hello friends, so today I am going to tell you what is Selenium and in which way it can be utilized. That is not only a tool of testing or automation, there are so many other applications of that. Selenium automation browser is available there. So there are two things, one is IDE and one is framework. Using that you can do programming in different languages like Java or etc. So as you are looking on the site Selenium automates browser, so what is the use of that? It will be opening the browser automatically and form will be filled by with the help of that. So first of all, I am going to create a very simple web application and then I will be applying Selenium on that with the help of Java framework. Otherwise there is one more tool that is you can say that is not only the tool, that is one plugin, and that can be installed on Google Chrome or it can be installed with Mozilla or any other browser. So there are so many type of softwares are available with that, like Selenium standalone server, Internet Explorer driver, Selenium client and web driver language binding. So such type of tools are available on this site. You can go and you can check. But now in NetBean we are going to test that. So first of all, you have to concentrate on this web application. Inside that I created a very simple thing like this index.html. As you are looking in this HTML page, I am going to create two text boxes. Everybody, I am considering for this video, he or she is having the knowledge of some JSP and HTML forms. So you are looking that I am going to create two text boxes inside that. First text boxes I am creating for the first name and second text box I am creating for the last name. Now I am going to create three radio buttons and all are belonging to the same group because I am selecting type radio and name is gender for all, but value is different. So you can select male, female or others from that. One more geo element I am creating, and that is in the form of checkbox. You can see that I have a car or I have a bike, you have to choose that. And after that I am creating a selection box or you can say a drop down. Inside that I am providing four options, which car or which vehicle you are having, like Volvo, Saab, Mercedes or Audi. So four options are there. And in last you are looking that I have to submit this form, so I am creating a submit button. But once more you can concentrate on this one, that new jsp.jsp page is there, that will be receiving all the values or some values from this HTML form. So right now I am not receiving all the values from that, and you can see just I am applying request.getParameter first name, request.getParameter last name and get parameter gender, and all such values will be received and they will be displayed back on that. So first of all, I created a very simple basic web application. You can say this is a web application, and now I am going to run this. When I am running it, then you will be seeing Tomcat will be started and this HTML page will be running inside the web browser, and my default web browser is this Google Chrome. So just wait for a second and then you will be seeing Google Chrome will appear on the screen and you will be seeing a form. So at this place you can fill some values, like I am filling AMITA Amita, and just I am writing KUMARI Amita Kumari, and just I am selecting female, and then I am selecting I have a bike, and then what vehicle I am saying that Saab, and then submit. Then just after submitting you are seeing that Amita Kumari female is being displayed, but just you will be surprised that only three values are there, because you can see that I have not received remaining values. I am receiving only first name, last name and gender only. So I think now it is clear to you. So in my web application there are two things, one is index.html, another one is new JSP page. Now we are going to apply a testing on that, and that is why I created one Selenium. Just you can just wait a second and then you will see. So if you remember, I can open my HTML page, or time to time we'll be seeing that what are the names of all these in HTML. So first of all, I want to tell you that how to set up this Selenium. To set up this Selenium, just see, there are two important files, and I am telling about the window. Just for the setup of this Selenium, you have to consent.
हेलो दोस्तों, हमारी वीडियो को लाइक एवं सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें। आपको हमारी वीडियो को लाइक करने के लिए इस आइकन पर क्लिक करना होगा, तथा सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए आपको इस बॉक्स पर क्लिक करना पड़ेगा। आप हमारी वीडियो को सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए इस बेल आइकन पर भी क्लिक कर सकते हैं। इन दोनों का एडवांटेज आपको ये रहेगा कि जब भी हमारी कोई नई एक इंटरेस्टिंग वीडियो आएगी, तो आपके यूट्यूब अकाउंट के टॉप पर बेल आइकन पर एक अलर्ट आ जाएगा।
Trade on two important files. Now I am showing these two files to you. One is Selenium Server Standalone Jar. Basically, this is a framework. With the help of that, you will be doing programming in Java. So it will be providing basic methods and functions, and those are required to start the testing of any web application with the help of Java. So this is very, very important, and you have to concentrate on that. And second thing, a Chrome driver. Not only I am saying that Chrome driver is required, you can understand, whatever web browser you are using, accordingly you have to download the driver of that from internet, from the Selenium side, and all the necessary links of Selenium driver and jar file available in my video. So this Chrome driver is to be downloaded. Now these two important files are there. After setup of these two, your program will be running fine. But till now I have not explained anything about this program, but before explaining this program, you have to understand the complete setup of it. So just go in properties, and now you can see at this place libraries are there, and you have to give the path of this Selenium Server Standalone 3.2.0.jar. And from which place? Because in my PC it is already added, so just I can remove it, and once more I can add so that you can understand. So just go back here and select your jar file there. After the selection of that, if any error is there, then that will be removed easily. Now second thing, as I told you about the driver, then path of that driver exe will be given here. Then you can see the complete path is to be given here, and this is necessary. Without that, your browser will not be opened. And I am telling once more that this Chrome driver only for Google Chrome. If you are going to use your different web browser, then different driver will be required for that. So I think it is clear to all. And one more thing, necessarily you have to put two backslashes there. Two backslashes are there, okay. And I think if you study Java, then you know very well that what is the use of that. One will be used as a backslash, and another is being used as a escape sequence. So the name of that driver, by which parameter it will be recognized by the Java. So it is available there, webdriver.chrome.driver. Okay. So very first line will be to set the property, or we have to tell where is the Chrome driver, and which web browser will be opened when we are going to test web application. Now whatever web application you are going to test, you have to give the path of you have to give the complete URL of that web page. So that web page URL is given here, and you have to create one object, and object name is driver, okay, and class of that is web driver, and it will be created on Google Chrome. So I created in my Google Chrome, and now we are giving the complete path. Now from which place this will come? So you can see recently I tested my one web application. So just you can just go back, and you can copy this complete, okay, and then paste it here. You can paste it at this place. Now as you remember that GUI element, that is text box in my this HTML page, and name of that is first name. So I am giving first name there, and driver dot find element. So it will find the element by name. If you want to give ID, then you can give ID also there, but you have to do necessary changes there. Okay, sometimes some people are giving ID, some are giving name. So at this place I am giving, just you can see at this place I am recognizing the first text box by name. If I am using ID there, then you have to use ID at this place. Okay, so name, and just in this I am going to refer my first name that is available in my HTML page. Now last name is being referred there. Now send keys, what is the meaning of send keys? Means now I will be writing Swati in that text box, it will be written automatically. Now send keys Garg, I am writing Garg in that automatically. So exactly in the same way you can see all other elements are there, but now you can see because the purpose of Selenium is to fill the form automatically and click on that automatically, so that when we are testing web applications, then we have to fill the forms many times and we have to click that. So if there are 100 number of elements and then I am filling every time I am getting wrong result, then I am filling every time, then 100 number of times, 100 number of fields filling is not an easy task, and that will be very time consuming. So it will be better that we can write Selenium application, and whenever we have to test, no one need to fill the form every time. Okay, so now because this is element, because now you can go to index.html and at this place you are looking. Now I am going to refer this radio button, because radio button is not having a single value like the text box, so receiving all these values there is a different provision for that purpose. That is why I has created a list. And now what is the difference between this? At this place I am using find element and at this place I am using find elements. And what is the name gender? This gender is the name of my radio button. Now you can see here, when I have to select this radio button, then I have to click on it. So same provision is being used in my NetBean. Whenever you selected this gender and you want to select the second radio button, then you have to call click on this get method. Okay, so exactly in same way for checkbox I did it. Now go for the selection box. So whatever is to be selected, you can go by select by index or select by name, you can write that. Okay, so I think up to this it is okay. Driver dot find element, now I have to click on the submit button, and name of my submit button in my web application is SB. So I am getting that, I am referring that first, and then I am calling click, so that click can be done automatically. So friends, now be serious and see it very carefully. Now I am going to run this application. You will be seeing that the complete web form will be filled automatically and it will be submitted. So please see it very seriously, because it will be going on very fast. Now see it. So it has been filled, and now it has been clicked, and now you are looking new JSP page is there. Once more I am doing, you have to see it very seriously friends, and then feel it. Okay, just wait, form filled, now it will be submitted automatically. So this is the use of Selenium. And now one more thing I want to tell about it. If you are just applying one wait statement there, that means sleep in Java, then you will see it will not be working very fast. It will take some time after filling the form. You can see the form easily, and then it will be clicked automatically. So now just wait and see. It has been filled. Now it has been submitted, and that is why you are getting seeing the result. Friends, now you will be thinking, if we can fill the form automatically, then there are so many misuses of that. Means somebody has created the web form on his own site. Now we can fill that in a night. Now what is the solution for that? So that is why scientists and engineers invented CAPTCHA that require human interaction and that control this type of automation. So that will stop the misuse of such type of tools like Selenium. But it is really very beautiful tool. Just test this. If you have any query, any doubt, then you can come back and you can give that in comment and you can ask to me. Okay, thank you friends.